हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल पैथोलॉजी मास्टर। माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर पार्थ गोस्वामी, आई एम द कंसल्टेंट पैथोलॉजिस्ट एंड टुडे आई विल गिव यू अ शॉर्ट ट्यूटोरियल ऑन एडिनोइड सिस्टिक कार्सिनोमा। वी विल ट्राई टू कवर द होल एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ एडिनोइड सिस्टिक कार्सिनोमा इन द डिटेल। सो गाइज, अवर लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव फॉर द टूडेज टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन ऑन एडिनोइड सिस्टिक कार्सिनोमा इज टू अंडरस्टैंड द डेफिनेशन ऑफ एडिनोइड सिस्टिक कार्सिनोमा। Then we need to understand which are the common sites for development of such tumor. We need to understand the prevalence, genetics of disease, how to diagnose adenoid cystic carcinoma, and the treatment and prognostic portion of adenoid cystic carcinoma. So first we will start with the definition and the common site of occurrence of adenoid cystic carcinoma. So guys, this is the malignant epithelial tumor. It's a epithelial malignancy, and the common site for occurrence of this particular epithelial carcinoma is salivary gland. We know very well that in our body we have the major and minor salivary glands, so the parotid, then submandibular glands and the sublingual glands are known as a major salivary glands, while in the oropharynx, nasopharynx and the sinus we have the minor salivary glands. So here we can have minor salivary glands, it can be seen over the tongue as well. So this particular tumor is more common in minor salivary gland as compared to major salivary glands. So it's commonly seen in minor salivary glands, and then it can be seen in the major salivary gland as well. So the common site is minor salivary gland. Alright, see guys, this adenoid cystic carcinoma can occur in other sites as well, which is a very less common sites, but it can be seen. So it can be seen over the breast as well, it can develop in breast. This particular tumor can occur in lacrimal gland as well. Lung is also one of the sites for adenoid cystic carcinoma, and very rarely this tumor can occur in brain and trachea. So this is regarding the sites of adenoid cystic carcinoma. Now we will see the prevalence of tumor. So guys, this is the third most common malignant salivary gland tumor. It's very important. It's the third most common malignant tumor of salivary glands. The first common malignant salivary gland tumor is mucoepidermoid carcinoma. Second one is polymorphous adenocarcinoma, and this is the third one. And if we talk regarding the mean age group, then it's around the 57 year. So this tumor is common in the age group between 50 to 60 year. And usually it has a equal gender predilection. Alright. Now we will see the genetic of adenoid cystic carcinoma. What is the genetic? So guys, this particular malignancy developed because of activation of one oncogenic transcription factor. That is the MYB gene. This is the most important MCQ, guys. The MYB gene mutation is related to this malignancy. And usually you can observe the translocation of certain genes like that of MYB, NFIB or MYBL1 and NFIB gene fusion. So because of translocation, these two gene fusion can be seen. Either you can have MYB, NFIB or you can have MYBL1 NFIB gene fusion. And when you have the doubt regarding the diagnosis, particularly when you are doing the histopathological examination and you are not sure about the diagnosis, then this genetic study by the polymerase chain reaction can be helpful for the diagnosis. So PCR testing can be done to check for genetics of the tumor. All right. Now diagnosis, how to diagnose this particular case of adenoid cystic carcinoma. So guys, to diagnose the adenoid cystic carcinoma, first of all you have to take the history. The patient will give history regarding the pain in the mouth. In the oral cavity, the patient will have pain. The patient will observe, sometimes patient himself observe the growth inside the oral cavity. So you can have the growth inside the oral cavity, and because of nerve involvement, the patient can complain tingling or loss of sensation in the affected area. So the tingling and the loss of sensation sometimes can be observed, but the main observation is pain and growth inside the oral cavity. Alright, now you have seen the growth inside your oral cavity, so you will take the biopsy and that will be sent for histopathological examination. So after the tissue processing, the slide will be prepared and you will observe it under the microscopic examination, that is called as histopathological examination. So the prepared slide can be seen under the microscope and you can diagnose the case of adenoid cystic carcinoma. We will see the morphological finding later on in the slides. Now if the cancer has been detected by histopathological examination, you have to check for metastasis by CT scan or PET scan. So to check for metastasis, you can do the CT scan and the PET scan. So guys, the most important method for diagnosis is histopathological examination, means microscopic morphological examination. Alright, now if you observe this particular tumor under microscope, then histopathologically it's a tumor of salivary gland and it is particularly biphasic salivary gland tumor. Now this is very important. What do you mean by biphasic tumor? Means I want to say that in this tumor you will have the gland, right? It is the tumor of salivary gland. This gland will be lined by cuboidal cells, right? These cuboidal cells are your ductal epithelial cells. So inside the gland you will have the lining of ductal epithelial cells, and surrounding this ductal epithelial cell you will have hyperchromatic, excessively darkly stained angulated nucleus with scanty cytoplasm that will cover this ductal epithelial cell, and these cells are known by the name myoepithelial cells. So the outer lining is formed by hyperchromatic angulated epithelial cell. So these are your myoepithelial cell. So you will have two type of cell in this particular tumor. You will have inner lining of ductal epithelial cell and outer lining is of myoepithelial cell. It can be seen, myoepithelial cell can be seen between the gland as well, means it can be seen in the stroma as well. And this myoepithelial cell having the characteristic appearance of darkly stained nucleus, hyperchromatic scanty cytoplasm, and they will cover the gland, so giving the appearance like that of basaloid. So it will have basaloid appearance, myoepithelial cells. Alright, so histopathologically you can observe the four common patterns. So the patterns observed are cribriform pattern, then you can have tubular pattern, then you can have solid pattern, or you can have sclerosing pattern. So these four pattern is observed in adenoid cystic carcinoma, and the common pattern that is observed is cribriform carcinoma, and it is the diagnostic for the adenoid cystic carcinoma. If you observe this pattern, then you have to think about the adenoid cystic carcinoma for the sure. So this is the cribriform carcinoma pattern. In this image you can see the cribriform pattern. This is the cribriform pattern, guys. I will explain you in the detail in the later on in the slides. So guys, in the cribriform pattern you will have the cells that will be arranged around the gland like clear space, and so they will form pseudocyst. I mean to say that if you observe this slide carefully, then you can see that these cells, just see guys, this gland here, you have the cells that will cover the cystic like space. This space is covered by darkly stained epithelial cells. It can be ductal or myoepithelial. So the cells will cover the cystic space like cyst, right? So you have the cells around the space, and that is known by the name pseudocyst. So in the cribriform pattern you will observe the pseudocyst, and in the pseudocyst you will not have any lining. If you observe this pseudocyst, then in the inner side you don't have ductal epithelial cells. So that is the characteristic of cribriform pattern, that is the characteristic of pseudocyst. Inner lining is absent. That's why it is known by the name pseudocyst. And you can see that the pseudocyst is filled with eosinophilic or sometimes basophilic material. This particular material is stained with one special stain that is PAS stain. So it can be positive with periodic acid sieve stain. So the cyst is filled with eosinophilic material. You can see that all cyst is filled with eosinophilic material, and that is the characteristic of this tumor. Alright, so guys, in addition to the presence of pseudocyst, you can also observe few tiny glands as well. Here is the presence of tiny glands as well. Now this gland will be lined by ductal epithelial cell as well as myoepithelial cells. So they are called as a gland. So in the gland you will have ductal epithelial cell as well as myoepithelial cell. So I will explain you in this image. See guys, this is the pseudocyst, right? Alright, these all are the pseudocysts that is filled with eosinophilic material, and that is lined by darkly stained cell. But if you observe carefully, here you can see the tiny glands. These glands are lined by ductal epithelial cell as well as myoepithelial cells. So glands also can be seen in this adenoid cystic carcinoma. Here also there is a presence of tiny glands that is also seen in this 10x view. So guys, for the diagnosis you need a gland as well as the pseudocyst. So if pseudocyst and the glands both are present, then your diagnosis will be adenoid cystic carcinoma. Alright, here also you can see the gland, and this is the pseudocyst. This is a pseudocyst and here is tiny gland. So that is regarding the diagnosis of adenoid cystic carcinoma. Alright. Now guys, sometime it has been observed that the cribriform pattern is not seen predominantly, but you will see a glandular pattern and the solid pattern predominantly. So this group of tumor is higher grade. It is the tumor of grade 2 and grade 3. In the grade 1 tumor, you will have only cribriform pattern. But if you have both cribriform and glandular pattern equally, then it's a grade 2 tumor. And if you see only solid pattern, that is seen in this diagram. Here there is a presence of only basaloid cells, and it's showing only solid nesting pattern. So these are the high grade tumors, and prognosis, this is the high grade 3 tumor, and the prognosis is very bad for such tumor. Perineural invasion is commonly seen in this tumor, and it is the characteristic for the diagnostic of adenoid cystic carcinoma. So in the adenoid cystic carcinoma, you can have cribriform pattern, you can have gland and the perineural invasion. Means the cells are invading, cells are present just around the nose, that is perineural invasion. Alright, now if your tumor is high grade, like that of grade 2 or 3, then your prognosis is very poor, and you have the more chance of metastasis, and so patient can die because of high grade tumor. In the high grade tumor, you will have more aneplasia, means you will have more high NC ratio, more hyperchromatic nuclei, and there can be more variation in size and shape. So aneplasia will be more. And you will have necrosis as well in the high grade tumor. The mitosis also will be more, like that of greater than 10 per 10 high power field. So these three criteria, these three characteristic finding is seen in high grade tumor. Okay. Now if we do the spatial immunohistochemistry stain, then in the IHC, these ductal epithelial cells will be positive for certain cytokeratins, like that of CK7, then carcinoembryonic antigen and CAM5.2. The covering myoepithelial cell will be positive for S100, smooth muscle actin, calponin, P63, P40, GFAP and the P40. And the other positive IHC markers are lysozyme, lactoferrin, CD117 and c-kit. So when you have the diagnostic difficulty morphologically, then at that time you can perform the IHC stain for the diagnosis of the tumor. And if you still have the doubt regarding the diagnosis with IHC stain also, then you can go for molecular testing. Alright, Now, as far as the treatment of adenoid cystic carcinoma is concerned, the main treatment is surgical excision with adequate removal of the margin. That is enough. But sometime after surgery, you need to give an adjuvant or palliative radiotherapy as well. Alright, so this is the mode of treatment, surgical excision and radiotherapy. But if your tumor is metastasized, it is inoperable, or if your tumor is recurrent, or you have the residual disease after the surgery, at that time you have to do fast neutron therapy. That is very effective and it is the latest mode of treatment for this carcinoma. And if the metastasis has occurred widespread, if you have the widespread metastasis, then only treatment option remaining is chemotherapy. Alright. Now, if we talk regarding the prognosis of adenoid cystic carcinoma, then prognosis is very good. Because it's a very well differentiated tumor. Most of the patients have grade 1 or grade 2 tumor. And so prognosis is very good. But the recurrence is common for this particular malignancy. And the 5-year survival rate is 55 to 90%. So we can say that overall it's a good prognostic tumor. Alright, so guys, thank you very much, and this is all about the adenoid cystic carcinoma.